Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will be discussing about the scope information and how these scope informations are represented such that the scope is maintained for the global and the local variables. Now let us try to understand how to represent these scope informations. Any of the variable or any of the identifier which has been represented in the program has a certain region of the validity. And the region of the validity has to be maintained in the form of some of the data structures. We have already studied about the symbol table. You should also have an idea about the symbol table and the various data structures which are used to represent the symbol table. But we need to maintain a temporary symbol table just to maintain the scope information about the various identifiers. Here in this lecture, before proceeding further, I would also like to make you clear about the identifiers. Let us say we have declared a variable integer x. So integer x is a variable, okay, and then void function. This function which has been named as funcition function, this also is an identifier. So any user defined name inside a program is an identifier. Okay, and we need to store the information about these identifiers while doing the lexical analysis in the program. So now here in this program, what you can see that we have four different variables, four different identifiers: integer x, function, integer y, p and q, which are also the integer. So not only four, but in fact we have five different identifiers here. And we need to maintain the information about these identifiers that are in the symbol table. Okay. Now, some of the variables or some of the identifiers have their validity globally. For example, the x variable is a global variable. It means its validity will be throughout the program. But if you talk about the variables p and q, these are the local variables with respect to the function, and their validity is only up to the time when the function is there. Okay, if a function is called, function is terminated, the validity of the variables p and q will finish. So there are certain rules for representing the scope information for a block structured language. So these rules are, let's say there is a block p and there are some names defined inside that block p. So the validity of those names will remain only by the time the block B is active. Once the block B finishes, all those names will remain invalid. So while opening of that block and while closing of that block, the life of the names written inside that block will be up to the time when that block is active. Once the block is inactive, means the block has finished, every name written inside that block will remain invalid. Now the another thing is, let's say we have a nested block wherein the B2 block is representing the outer block and B1 block is representing the block inside the block B2. So if the names are defined in the block B2, those will be valid for B1 block also. All those names which are defined inside the block B1 will be valid only for the B1 block but not for the B2 block. Let's say there is a variable x defined for a block B2. So that x will be valid for B2 also and for the B1 also. But if we are redefining the same name inside the B1 block, that is also allowed. Okay. So the rule is saying if B1 is nested within the B2, then the names that is valid for B2 is valid for B1 as well, unless the names identifier is redefined in B1. So here you can see that there is a B2 block and there is a B1 block. B2 is the outer block and the B1 is the inner block. Any of the scope information which are of this kind of the nature which is allowed to be nested, we need to maintain a data structure known as the symbol table. But the more complicated organization of the symbol table is required for maintaining such informations. Wherever we have the scope of varying kind, the symbol table is required to be maintained in a more complicated manner,
such that the list of association between the names and the attributes can be maintained. Now, whenever we have to maintain the information about the names written inside the block, then a new symbol table is required to be created, which is a temporary symbol table, and that symbol table is required to be maintained on the stack. And once the block finishes, we will be popping that symbol table because the validity of that block has finished. So for example, in the kind of the code that we have written here, there are three different kind of the things. One is the integer x, one is the function f, and a function g. So the validity of x function, x variable, f function, and g function will be throughout the program. A block is written inside the function f, but this block is valid only for a certain duration. Okay. Now let's try to understand the same symbol table management for the same code that we have taken. Here we need to maintain a global symbol table which will store the information about the x variable, the function f, and the function g. So three different columns are there in this global symbol table. One is the identifier that we have to store the information for. The second one is representing the type of the identifier, and the third one is representing the type of the information or type of the identifier. Now the x is of integer type, which is a variable. F is a function, which is of void type. G is a function, which is of integer type. Okay, so the global symbol table is required to be maintained for this section of the code. Once we enter in the function f, there are three things to be maintained. So on the left hand side of the global symbol table, we are taking a new symbol table, and this new symbol table is storing the information about the parameter m, which is the parameter for function f, and the variables x and y. Now the m is the parameter, so its type is parameter. In the second column, we are actually maintaining the type of the identifier. X and y are the variables. Parameter m is of integer type, and x and y are of the float type. So we need to maintain another symbol table for function f. Now when the function f is active, we have a block inside the function f which is having the information, or which is having the names I, j, u, and v. So we need to maintain the information about these parameters also. Once the block will open, the symbol table for this will be maintained, and once the block will be closed, the symbol table will be popped from the stack. So we have the information I, j, u, and v. All these are the variables, and all of these are of integer type. So there is a block inside the function f. We need to maintain the symbol table for this as well. Okay. Now once the block finishes, this symbol table will be popped out. We have another function g. So we need to maintain the symbol table for this as well. On the right hand side of the global symbol table, we are maintaining the symbol table for g. It has a parameter n of integer type and a variable t of float type. So we are maintaining the symbol table of this g function also. Whenever the g function will be called, the symbol table will be maintained, and whenever the g function will finish, this symbol table will be popped. So here you can see that the symbol table is looking like a tree structure. And in this tree structure, we are actually creating the node whenever a particular block is called or block is created. And when the block finishes, we will be removing that element, or we will be removing that node from the tree. Okay, so here it looks like the tree, but we are actually maintaining the stack, wherein when the block we are entering the block, the symbol table is maintained, and when we are exiting the block, this symbol table is popped. Okay, so this way we are maintaining the global and the local information in the form of the tree, or you can say in the form of the stack. So this is the way how do we represent the scope information. The scope are of two types. One is the global scope and one is the local scope. Global scope means the names which will remain valid throughout the life of the program. And the local scope means those will be valid only up to the life of the block. So for every block, a new symbol table will be created, which will be stored on the stack. And as soon as that block will finish, we will pop that block from the stack. Thank you.